Hello and welcome to Indian Express Online. The Uttarakhand High Court today quashed the center's imposition of the president's rule in the state. I have with me my colleague Amrit Lal to discuss and analyze the order. So Amrit, what we have seen is a very dramatic day of developments and the order was very sharp. What is your first reading of the order?
So in a way, we were expecting it, considering the kind of remarks the court was making in the last 2-3 days during the hearing. We knew that court had taken a very serious had a serious concern about the way the whole thing had panned out in Uttarakhand. So interesting thing about this is basically that court very clearly said that it is against the federal spirit of the constitution to dismiss an elected government. Then it's and the use of Article 356, and it also gave us a subtle hint about that, you know, the practice of Congress in the past itself. The BJP received a major rap when it said that, you know, you're trying to introduce a chaos, introduce chaos in the system. You're basically, you know, this whole decision to dismiss an elected government, and you are trying to use a magnifying lens to find an opportunity to dismiss state government. So those are very strong words. And the ground rule, basically, the court has reminded that is the Bommai judgment of 1994, where it is very clearly stated that the floor test is where the majority of a government has to be decided.
Right. So this is very interesting because the imposition of the president's rule happened a day before when the floor test was supposed to happen. Considering that this is a decision taken at the highest level, at the central government, the court order has to be a massive embarrassment for the central government.
I think so. So the whole, besides basically questioning the decision, the court also said a lot of the things which the center said as material to back its claim that there has to be a dissolution of the house. Court said that it doesn't match. Which I think is the most embarrassing thing, because you know, you also have the president being dragged in. Now, that's something which he would not be happy about. That he would, as a constitutional head, he's expected to do the, if there is a recommendation from the cabinet, he's supposed to endorse it. The fact is that he also expects that due diligence has been followed before the proposal is made. That doesn't seem to have happened. So the politics of it, there is a clear political overreach where the BJP seems to be wanting topple the Harish Rawat government.
This is coming with a background of cooperative federalism, and I mean a lot of noise, very different from what Congress was often accused of. Given that this order has now come into effect, how do you see things panning out in the future? Because one development has already happened.
The important Uttarakhand is basically that now you will have a floor test on April 29, where it will be decided whether Harish Rawat government has the numbers to stay on. That's the first aspect. The second thing is basically this whole debate about cooperative federalism or the BJP's position, Modi government's position towards state government, that will come under a scanner. Now you had Arunachal Pradesh where you had a very messy affair when governor was involved, all kinds of things were said about it then. Arvind Kejriwal and his government in Delhi. So he has already said that. I mean, one of the first remarks came from Kejriwal, questioning, asking Modi to look at the judgment closely, etc. So there is an immediate thing in Uttarakhand. There is also a lot of political impact which might get play out on the national scale.
Right. So I guess this theme of cooperative federalism and how it's panning out individually at center state level is something that is developing. Thanks for watching Indian Express.